into the college of your choice. I want to show you what's happening in China. Brace for it. Look at that picture. Students in one class seen hooked up to IVs with what I will call some sort of supplement designed to help them study better for important college entrance exams. Methinks it's an amino acid, but our senior medical correspondent, Elizabeth Cohen, has been looking into this and what this could mean for college-bound students right here in the good old U.S. of A, where we wouldn't think of doing this. Elizabeth Cohen, what are those kids doing?
Oh, you're right. It is amino acids. That's what we're told, Ashley. And when you look at those pictures, it's clear that the teachers know about this. Not only do they know about it, but actually it's being supplemented by the school. The kids pay a little bit of money, and the school supplements the rest to have these IVs going into their arms. Ashley, this is really nothing like the United States in that they're studying for these college entrance exams that will literally influence their entire life. It's not like the SAT where it's a piece of their admissions. It is everything. Mm. And so they say, look, if we want to get a little bit of a mental edge, we're going to get it. Now, what's interesting here is there's really not any proof that this will help them. There's some suggestion that amino acids might sort of combat mental fatigue to some degree, but it's not entirely clear. So, you know, I'm not really sure if this is going to help them or not. And I have to wonder, who put those needles in? I mean, is there a school nurse, or did they do it for each other? I mean, I don't even want to think about it.
I mean, it looks hideous. It really did. That image is just sort of harrowing to think all these kids and how many of them might have been pressured into it because everyone else was doing it, right, and they would be left behind if they didn't. I think the bigger question also here, Elizabeth, is if what you're saying is true, we're not really sure if the amino acids can give you that great mental edge. Do we know the opposite? Can it do something bad?
You know, it really depends on the dosage. If they're taking lots of this, it could have an effect on their kidneys. I don't know if they're doing this for just a couple of weeks or if they're doing this long term. I don't know what the dosage is. You know, probably they don't really know either. So it's a pretty scary thing. It really is.
You know, Elizabeth, it's been a year or two since I was studying for my finals. Three or four. And I do remember admitting live on television that I took some of those caffeine pills to try to get through those real cram nights. But here in the U.S., have we progressed differently? Are we so different from those kids in China? Albeit the image is startling, but how are we faring?
Well, you know, it's interesting because that image is so startling and we think, oh my gosh, how can they do this? Well, I want to introduce you to a young man that I met a year ago who was studying for his finals. His name is Jared. He's a college student in Alabama, and he is very open about taking Adderall. He buys it from his friends, which is totally illegal, and he used it to get through the night. So, you know, there's no IV in his arm, but he's taking Adderall, and he and other young people we talked to said everybody does it.
And that's,
I mean, obviously not everybody,
sure,
but a lot of kids do it. So you don't have the image of IV bags hanging down, but they are taking prescription drugs prescribed to someone else.
And while that's not legal, you know, there are all the monster energy drinks that people are slamming down at 4 or 5 per night,
right,
as well. So.